Hi guys, and welcome to a quick comparison today, and this time I try to make it really short as I'm also not too interested in this comparison. Today we're going to compare the JBL Charge 4 against the Teufel Rockstar Go, I think. There's also the Cross, which I might check out. It's the version which is made to compete with the Extreme 2, so maybe it's better. And you can already hear it. I'm not that impressed with the speaker. It's just another speaker that goes for $150 and is not better than the JBL. It's not horrible, it's just an average speaker. It looks pretty nice, quality is pretty great, but there's nothing more really separating it from the rest. It has more stereo than the rest, but the Denon and Vaya has better stereo processing even. So as you can hear, it's not really an outstandingly good speaker, and that's why I just want to keep it short today and just play 4 or 5 tracks, so one at max volume to compare those two. If we have some interruptions in the recording again, don't wonder, it's not a crappy recording or something. It's because of my iPhone. The Bluetooth connection is pretty weak in the last few days, so today and yesterday I have been constantly getting issues with the Bluetooth connection on any speaker with the iPhone. I really hope Apple fixes this, as it's really inappropriate for a phone of this price tag. But anyways, let's just get into it. Just like always, I'm wearing binaural microphones to give you the most realistic listening experience, and for those you need to wear headphones in order to get the best impression of the speakers. So make sure to put them up and enjoy the video. Again, a quick disclaimer before I start to play the music. The speakers are not fake, or my video isn't fake, since many people think that, just because the drivers aren't moving. I'm recording the audio separately, about 1 meter away from the speaker, directly in front of them, and then I take pictures of the speakers afterwards to insert them in order to show you which one is playing right now, so nothing is fake here and it's just pictures with separate audio.
Waiting for a change. I love, I love, I love. take my hand. Can you walk with me? In some town it feels like eternity. Can I turn the tide? I'll give back my pride. Can I make you proud? Won't you say it out loud? Gonna take you down to the burning.
So after finishing this comparison, my overall impression of the Teufel got even worse. So I think it's not an average speaker anymore, I think it's rather a under average speaker. There are many issues with it. So first of all, just speaking sound wise, the JBL just sounds better with any kind of music. Of course, keep in mind it's not stereo, but the mid range is just a lot more smooth sounding. Even the treble is better, although the JBL always has had some issues with treble performance, as there's just one driver for all frequencies, while the Teufel at least has two drivers, so maybe that's less work for them to do. But the JBL just sounds nicer overall. The bass is a bit punchier, although the overall bass, when it comes to the frequency measurement, is quite similar. I think that the JBL sounds better, as of course it's not only about the bass performance. Midrange and treble of course also influence the bass performance as well, so if you have, for example, like the Teufel, some weird stereo processing, which adds some kind of mid-range boost or something, then the bass will be swallowed, and that's just why the JBL sounds so much cleaner on any kind of volume. Especially on higher volumes, the Teufel just gets noisy. You could hear it's louder on max volume than the JBL, so maybe it's better for a small party, but it's just noise, so your guests won't say that it's an amazing audio system. They will just, I don't know, maybe even complain that it sounds weird because it's just compressed, it sounds like it's pushed too far, while the JBL nicely keeps everything together. On low volumes, none of them have loudness compensation, so none of them gets a point here. And also, since I've started building speakers a bit, I also started to rate speakers after their construction, or take a look at their construction. So for example, with the JBL, you can see there's one full-inch drive at the front and two passive radiators on the left and right, in some kind of push-pull or push-push, however you want to call it, configuration, which means that they cancel out each other's vibration. While the Teufel, on the other hand, has all drivers on the front, especially that big heavy passive radiator, which is just a stupid idea in my opinion, as it moves across the table all the time. And not only this, the vibrations also just make the sound worse, they make everything more distorted, as of course the entire thing is rattling like crazy. So if you have even a normal table, like I do, it just won't stand still. Even on normal volumes, it will move across the table slowly. I experienced this with a small speaker I built. It's a small monitor and it has two small, pretty heavy subwoofers on each side. One time, one of them just lost the connection, and there was just one of them playing. The entire thing quickly moved across the table. It was even more extreme than with the Teufel, and this is just why I personally would recommend always doing it like JBL or DVLE, with this kind of push-push, push-pull kind of design approach. Another issue of the Teufel, which I want to quickly address, is the positioning of the full-range drivers. So of course they wanted to get more stereo, but it seems like their stereo processing wasn't enough for them, so they decided to place two full-range drivers on an angle facing outwards. I don't know how many degrees that is, but it's enough to make it sound weird. So if you tilt the speaker to the left or right, the treble will get better. So if you listen directly in the middle, which you should, because then you will get both left and right channel properly balanced, it somehow sounds weird and a bit covered. And then again, if you tilt it to the side, you will get nicer treble. So it's just a questionable design approach. But now I want to stop talking. The video is getting too long again. It should be a quick comparison. So if you enjoyed it, make sure to leave a like or subscribe to the channel to don't miss out on any new uploads in the future. And yeah, until then, have a great time and see you on the next one.